I'm gonna miss probably my friends and like routine, like waking up, seeing everyone, you know,
all my friends and like the teachers and just like, I don't know, everything.
Hi, tonight we're here at the Regency Palace for our senior prom, and we're having a good time, ready to have fun, and we just want to tell all our class members to have fun, enjoy themselves.
Sadly, we are also bringing one of the most important chapters in our lives to a conclusion. We began this chapter together, and we will end it together tomorrow at noon. However, tomorrow can also be viewed as a beginning, the start of another new experience.
For the class of 2001, may we never forget the incredible memories we have experienced and the strong friendships we have made.
To the class of 2001, congratulations everyone. I wish everybody the best and we'll see each other hopefully soon.
So to all those who are close to us, friends, family, and teachers, we say thank you. You have helped us grow into the men and women we are today. And it is because of your love that we will never be the same again.
I congratulate you on so much hard work already accomplished and so much of life already lived well. May God grant you good health, peace of mind, a courageous spirit, and a sincere love for all of creation, that each of you will make a lasting and creative impression on some part of our world.
As Winston Churchill once said, do not think of this as the end. Do not even think of this as the beginning of the end. Rather, think of this as the end of the beginning. Eustace provided us with a tremendous foundation. Now our goals extend even further. It is our turn to teach, to use our knowledge, strength, independence, and faith to reach out to others beyond this community which has prepared us and to fulfill the rest of our dreams.
Yes,
of course.
Oh my God, it was so scary.
I wasn't really scared. I was a little afraid because I didn't know anybody. But I met all my friends the first day of school.
I just remember I was like really overwhelmed because I went to a really small school. So 200 people, even though it's not that many, it seemed like a lot for first day. But we had a lot of fun. I just remember sitting here.
That was the scariest day. I hated my first day. I felt so lost. And I remember here being in the picnic area. Wow. Everybody was crowded together.
I don't remember anything about my first day. It was too traumatic. The uniforms, the teachers, the school, everything.
My first day at Eustace, I had the longest skirt and I felt like an idiot. My skirt was like down to the floor and I saw everybody's skirt. I was like, oh my God, everyone kept looking at me, but they probably weren't looking at me because of that.
I just remember all the girls liked me. I don't know what happened to that. Now I'm all alone.
The first day of school, I was so scared and I had no friends. I didn't know anyone. But Kim, come here, Kim. I met Kim before school started. And we met playing basketball, and she was the first person I met, and I'm still friends with her, which is kind of rare.
I remember the first day when I walked into Mrs. Larkin's class, and I had a big backpack on my back, and I was dragging my tennis bag behind me, and she said to me, "What are you doing with all those bags?" And I just turned to her and I said, "I don't know where to put them." So I think that's definitely what everybody remembers about me.
It is, like, yeah. Everything that you shared with your friends, like the junior trip, like sharing a room with
your junior. The shower cap.
Okay, all right.
I guess all the dances and preparing for like field day and spirit week and all the Sweet 16 parties, there was like a million of them.
Sitting out in the quad and just sitting and talking when it's a sunny day, that was the best.
Everything. I just loved being here at Eustace, the dances, the parties, all the Sweet 16s, just field day. Everything was like a great memory here.
Best memories. I DJ'd for the field day this year. That was really cool. Just chilling with all my buddies, all the parties, and everything about senior year, I guess.
Oh no, the school's full of memories. Tommy Tattoo's coming to school. Probably best memory.
Always remember the way we danced.
Yes, we danced. No, yes, yes, yes.
It's just a lot of good memories over these 4 years. Kind of sad, but it's kind of exciting, you know. Now we're really stepping onto the highway of life.
Senior year, definitely. Florida, Italy, Paris, Greece.
Definitely Italy.
Yeah. Just with your friends, just hanging out in the cab or the senior picnic area, playing cards. Sorry, Mr. Blessein. And just having fun.
Florida was really fun.
Florida was
the rock and roller coaster five times.
I'm gonna miss the people. Are great. We have like a really great class, and all the teachers, because we have teachers who really care about us. So
I'm gonna miss seeing my friends every day, because that's gonna be tough not seeing them every day, because I'm just so used to being around them and everything. So
I'm gonna miss my friends, and I'm gonna miss making film videos.
I guess just hanging around free periods with friends and stuff like that. And the cafeteria food.
I won't miss exams and I won't miss AP classes, but I'll miss all my friends.
Aww. Definitely the people. I'm gonna miss the people so much.
The big cookies. They don't have me today. I went in there and they didn't have any.
The stupid stuff, like walking through the hallways and
big cookies.
Big cookies from the calf and senior picnic area and the basketball locker room. I played basketball.
My friends.
All my friends.
I'll definitely miss all my friends, but especially the teachers and how much help that they've given us over the years, whatever the case may be.
The campus is cool. The teachers, I don't know. What am I going to miss?
The atmosphere.
Oh my God, you guys. I'm going to miss you guys. Oh my God, I love you.
Congratulations to everyone in our class. We had great 4 years here, and we're going to miss everyone and everything.
And it
didn't rain, and hopefully it won't rain for graduation.
Good luck to everyone in the class of 2001, and we'll miss you.
We love you.
It's been a great 4 years. We love you.
Okay.
And that's all. Mwah.
And congratulations to the class of 2001, Bishop Eustace gang. Come on now.
How do I breathe?
remember the first day of school. I'm sure most of us do. When Miss Larkin and Mrs. Williams came to each homeroom and said hi, and they introduced themselves and they said, "We're going to be your moderators, and we promise we're going to be here for the 4 years that you're here." So we just want to thank you for everything, and we have flowers and cards here that we want to present to you. Everyone, can we have a round of applause?
Regency Palace for our senior prom, and we're having a good time, ready to have fun, and we just want to tell all our class members to have fun, enjoy themselves.
Yeah, this took a lot of preparation, and it's all worth it. We're having so much fun, and we just hope that everyone will always cherish this night forever.
It's been a great 4 years, and we want to thank everyone for all the memories and wish everyone the best in college. And
we're going to miss you guys.
Yeah, we'll miss everyone.
It was fun.
Congratulations to myself and to the class of 2001.
Congratulations.
Rock on and congratulations.
It's an honor to be here, sit at the table with my best friends, my cousin. It's been a great 4 years. This is my sexy date, Andrea, right here.
Hi.
How lovely.
Anyway, it's been a great four years. I want to miss all you guys.
The evening's going unbelievable. I'm having a blast with all my friends. Got my girlie right here, eating some food. It's going good.
I'm speechless to be here with my four best friends and my other best friend that I've known since sixth grade. And also my team.
So far it's going really well. It's a lot of fun. Everybody looks gorgeous and the guys look very handsome. I started around 12 o'clock and it took me about from 12 to 4.
I woke up at 8:15 this morning and got my nails done at 10. And then I've been getting ready ever since.
Yep. I actually woke up at 11 because I wanted to be well rested for staying up all night. And I had a hair appointment at 2, and then I just was getting ready since then. So.
Nails take an hour and a half, hair takes an hour and a half, then you have to do the whole makeup and get dressed and pictures. It's a long process.
About a half an hour.
The prom has been incredible. The only problem is that the NBA didn't check with Eustace and decide that the Sixers would be playing on the same night as our prom.
Yeah, we're really upset about that.
But they keep announcing the score, and we did turn down our tickets that we had for tonight.
Yeah, we had front row seats.
Yeah, because we're friends with Alan Iverson. No, we're not. Right, that's all lies. We really do care.
Yeah, I don't follow the Sixers that much, but now I have to. But I don't know what's going on, because the guys are very disappointed. That's all I know.
The Sixers game is very important, and they should have a TV in there, that's all I have to say.
Definitely a TV.
That's a good idea.
One, two, three, four, come on, girls. I get on the floor, I come alive, y'all. Give me what you got, because I'm guaranteed to make you rock. I said one, two, three, four, come on, you're rock. What are you waiting for? I said a hip. The hip, the hip, hip, the hop, and you don't stop. Rock to the bang, to the left, slide to the right, crisscross, crisscross, cha-cha real smooth. To the left, to the left.
I get the pleasure of announcing the king and queen for the senior prom of Bishop Eustace Prep School for the year 2001. First, we'd like to announce the king. Is Mr. Peter Prisbakowski. Peter? Yeah. And Mrs. Williams will do the honors.
Come on, Peter.
The The queen is Lauren Brigger. Lauren. And Mrs. Larkin will do the honors. And now we give them a few moments on the dance floor.
Girlfriend is class king and queen of prom. I'm really appreciative, and throughout my 4 years at school, I've had a great time with this girl right here, and she's definitely made my high school days some of the most memorable days I've ever had. So thank you.
He's so cute. I just want to thank everyone, wish everyone good luck. This prom is awesome, and I'm so happy to be sharing it with my boyfriend, and I hope everyone's having a great time.
As freshmen, we were faced with a new and unfamiliar experience that encouraged us to form new friendships and develop a new sense of independence. We became members of a unique community that would serve to prepare us for adulthood. The next year, we walked onto the campus of Bishop Eustace, facing the new horizon of having a heightened responsibility as sophomores to set an example for the new incoming freshmen. We were no longer the youngest in the school, and more was expected of us.
Junior year, we entered the Eustace community as upperclassmen and prepared to face new challenges set before us, such as driving, taking the SATs, and most importantly, beginning our college search. The journey that we embarked upon to search for the right college seemed endless and filled with anxiety. Yet here we stand, having made our choices, ready to take on the new opportunities the college experience will offer each of us. More importantly, we stand together among our fellow classmates, teachers, and family members in the presence of God facing yet another new horizon. Sadly, we are also bringing one of the most important chapters in our lives to a conclusion. We began this chapter together, and we will end it together tomorrow at noon. However, tomorrow can also be viewed as a beginning, the start of another new experience that we will embark upon together, but finish apart from one another. We ask God to watch over us and help us to always remember the unity we share on this day as friends and classmates, for that is never ending.
A reading from the first book of Kings. Solomon stood and blessed the whole community of Israel, saying in a loud voice, "Blessed be the Lord who has given rest to the people of Israel, just as was promised. Not a single word has gone unfulfilled of the entire generous promise God made through the servant Moses. May the Lord our God be with us as the same God was with our ancestors, and may God not forsake us nor cast us off. May God draw our hearts so that we may follow God in everything and keep the commandments, statutes, and ordinances enjoined on our ancestors. May this prayer I have offered to the Lord our God be present day and night, that God may uphold the cause of his servant and of the people of Israel as each day requires, that all the peoples of the earth may know the Lord is God and there is no other. You must be wholly devoted to the Lord our God, observing God's statutes and keeping the commandments as on this day." The word of the Lord.
Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness and love.
Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness and love.
I will give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple and give thanks to your name. Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness and love. Because of your kindness and your truth, for you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me. Lord, thank you for your faithfulness and love. All the kings of the earth shall give thanks to you, O Lord, when they hear the words of your mouth, and they shall sing of the ways of the Lord. Great is the glory of the Lord. Lord, I thank you for your faithfulness and love.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Colossians. Because you are God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with heartfelt mercy, with kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, forgive whatever grievances you have against one another. Forgive as the Lord has forgiven you. Over all these virtues, put on love, which binds the rest together and makes them perfect. Christ's peace must reign in your hearts, since as members of the one body, you have been called to that peace. Dedicate yourselves to thankfulness. Let the word of Christ, rich as it is, dwell in you. In wisdom made perfect, instruct and admonish one another. Sing gratefully to God from your psalms, hymns, and inspired songs. Whatever you do, whether in speech or in action, do it in the name of the Lord Jesus. Give thanks to God, our Creator, through Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. From the lovely Rules and Regulations book of Bishop Eustace Preparatory, students are not permitted to eat or drink in the library resource area. But wait a minute, let's do one more. Oh, here's the list of fines. Parking in another space, how much? $5. I didn't know that. Littering on campus, how much? Two, we have a two. Failure to clean the dining hall tables. I didn't know that either. $5. I could have finished our capital campaign. All right, here it is. Here's your, what should we do here? Burn it.
For those who lead our Catholic Church community, may you bestow wisdom and guidance upon them to help these leaders with the many challenges they face now and in the future. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Father Joe, Mr. Blystein, Dr. D'Amore, and the administration of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School, may they always know how much we appreciate all that they have done for the class of 2001. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the faculty of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School, those who are still with us and those who have departed, each one has touched the lives of many students and have helped shape us into the young men and women we are today. May they continue to pass on the tradition of academic excellence and guidance with which we have been blessed. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our parents and guardians, they cared for us and helped us grow to become strong, talented, independent, and unique individuals. May you, dear God, help them through the transition as we set out to become adults. May they also realize how much we love them and appreciate their love and guidance. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our siblings and other family members, may you watch over them and help them through any difficulties they may encounter. May they receive compassion and support from us always. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
For the class of 2001, may we never forget the incredible memories we have experienced and the strong friendships we have made. As we each go our separate ways to find our own path in life, may the bonds we have formed here last beyond high school, and may our experiences stay with us as we travel through the incredible journey that is life. Also, may we always carry the spirit of Bishop Eustace within our hearts and become role models to the future students of the school. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those who have died, may they be at peace with God in heaven for all eternity. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all those who are ill, may they find comfort during their time of sickness. May their health be restored, and may they find peace in knowing you are always with them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of the personal intentions that we keep in the silence of our hearts, may the Lord grant us strength and the qualities needed to live our lives to their fullest potential. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, these young people come before you today, filled with hopes and dreams. Stay with them and guide them as they leave Bishop Eustace and move on in their life journeys. They are very special young men and women, and we are very proud of them. We love them and want them to be safe and happy. May they always stay close to you, no matter what they do. We ask this, as always, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
I'm going to Centenary College next year, and I'm studying equine business management.
Hi, I'm Dana Antonelli. I'm going to be going to Stockton State College and hoping to pursue a major in education.
Okay, I'm Tina Papern, and I'm going to Arcadia University next year, and I'll be studying graphic design, so hopefully everything will go good.
I'm Kim Gasparin, and I'll be going to the University of Michigan studying microbiology and biochemistry.
I'm Kim Miller. I'm going to the University of Delaware, and I'll be studying biology with a chemistry minor.
I'm Ryan Petrillo. That's my name. I'm going to University of Delaware, and I'm going to be studying English education, maybe minoring in recording technology, and hopefully moving on to becoming a rock star.
Hi, I'm Andrea Giordano. I'm going to Philadelphia University, and I will be majoring in fashion design.
My name is Kristen Ianeri, and I'm going to Albright College in Reading, Pennsylvania, and I'm going to be studying fashion design, hopefully costume design.
My name is Caitlin Marquardt, and I'm going to Atlantic County Cape College, and I'm going to be studying culinary arts, I'm going to be a chef.
My name is Raina Johnson, and I'll be going to St. Joseph's University to study history and political science.
Hi, I'm Stephen Jim Roglitz, and I'm going to Rider University. I don't know what I'm studying yet, but so I'm going undecided and everything.
My name's Liz Tomlin.
I'm Marina Capacasa.
We're both going to the College of New Jersey, formerly known as Trenton State. We're very proud of that. And we're majoring in soccer.
Yeah. And biology, kind of, but mostly soccer.
Just soccer for me.
Hi, my name's Leslie Waller, and next year I'm going to Western Maryland College, and I'm going to be studying political sciences and international studies, and I'm going to go to law school after that.
I'm Jeff Orm. I'm going to St. Joe's University, and I'll be studying business marketing.
I'm Melissa Abruzzi, and next year I'm going to Penn State main campus, and I'm going to be studying marketing.
And my name is Ashley Capalbo, and I'm going to St. Joseph's University, and I'll be studying psychology.
My name is Matt Laporta. I'm going to be headed to the University of Connecticut next year, and I'm going to be studying nursing. Don't really want to go into nursing, would like to go into medicine, but nursing is going to be my road to medicine.
Hi, I'm Laura Briglia. I'm attending Cornell University next year, and I'll be majoring in business.
Hi, I'm John Miramanesh. I'm going to St. Joe's University, and I'm undecided right now.
I'm Jeff Orm. I'm going to St. Joseph's University. My pal John here. I'm going to be studying business marketing.
I'm Siobhan Massey. I'm going to Princeton University, and I'm studying psychology with pre-med.
My final thoughts on my years at Eustace. It was fun. I'm about ready to get out of here, though. I've had enough.
But it was a great 4 years, and I made a lot of friends and everything, and I'm just really sad to go because I know I'll miss them all, but I hope we'll all keep in touch.
Overall, very good experience. Better than I would have had anywhere else.
I just want to wish everyone the best of luck in the future and congratulations on everything.
I'm just basically shocked that we actually been through it all, and I'm sad.
It's been the best experience of my life so far, but I'm sure that there are better experiences to come that Eustace has prepared me for. So I'm really excited about the future because I went to Eustace.
Okay, I want to say hi to the class 2001, wish everyone good luck, and I'll miss you guys.
It's been a really great time, and I wish everyone the best of luck, and they've all had an impact on my life in some way, and good luck, everyone.
It was great. I'm going to miss it. I love all my friends, and I'm just excited to graduate.
I've had so much fun at Eustace, and I'm going to miss all you guys so much. It's been great, so good luck next year.
I just want to thank everyone for the memories. I had a great time here, and I'm going to miss you all, and I hope that I can keep in touch with most of you.
I'm very sad.
Yeah, I never thought I'd ever say this, but I love this place, and I'm going to miss it.
I love everyone. No, that's all.
Everyone. Yeah. We have had the awesomest memories. Awesomest.
Is that a word?
Okay.
Word now.
The best memories, ever. I mean, just our friends and just everything. It's just been so awesome. It's been so great. And I just really hope that I still see everybody after graduation, because this is so awesome.
Yeah, I have to agree with her on that. Yeah,
best friends
till the end. Yeah, that's it.
Thank God I'm done. I'm glad. Sad to leave, but glad to go. Feeling a lot of different things at once.
A lot of good times. A lot of nice girls.
A lot of good friends.
A lot of good friends. Those are my final thoughts.
I loved Eustace. It's a great experience. You meet so many different people that maybe you thought you wouldn't have become friends with, but you really did. And just being in classes with people that are from different backgrounds and different walks of life gives you a real different perspective on the world. And I'm just gonna miss everyone that I've met here.
It was a lot of fun. Made a lot of friends. It was a really good time.
That's right. A blast. A BLAST. We're out of here. Peace.
Reverend Bernard Carman, members of the Board of Trustees, Dr. Coughlin, Reverend Capella, Mr. Blystein, distinguished faculty, honored guests, Reverend fathers, brothers, sisters, and members of the class of 2001, I would like to introduce Father Joseph Capella, our rector and chaplain, who will give the invocation. I ask that you remain standing for the national anthem and the Pledge of Allegiance.
To Brother Jim's welcome, I add my own to all of you here today. And first and foremost, I'd like to thank all the grandmoms and grandpops for putting the statue of the Blessed Mother in the window face out. It works. My good people, let us pray in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord God, on this feast of Pentecost, we thank you for the gift of your Spirit that lives within and among us. We are especially grateful today for the success of these, our graduates, whose accomplishments and lives give great promise for the enrichment of your kingdom on earth. Instill into their hearts gratitude to their parents and instructors, loyalty to their schoolmates, love for their alma mater, and most of all, the grace to live the motto of this great school and do what you will. Grant your grace, O God, and the fulfillment of all the just hopes and lofty aspirations of these young men and women. We beg of you an abundance of blessings upon this assembly, upon our families and friends, upon our church and our country, through your gracious goodness and the infinite merits of our Lord Jesus Christ. We humbly ask this benediction in your holy and sacred name, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
To the class of 2001, the 44th graduating class of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School, you are our honored guests. We honor you with our prayers and with our love. And we thank you for your fine representation today. We thank you for the hard work that you have pursued and accomplished in these 4 years. We also thank those who have gone before you, the alumni here today, and those who are here with us in other ways. We thank especially your parents, guardians, family, and all those who have brought you to this day. In all of your dreams, in all that you to which you aspire, we wish you many blessings, and we wish you all the best of luck. I would personally like to thank each and every one of you, because 4 years ago when you came here and your first day of school was my first day of school, but you're going, I'm not. I don't know if that's good or bad, but come back and visit. We especially like to congratulate the Hendricks family, whose son Stephen makes number 6 with more to go. Keep up the good work.
Thank you, Father Joe. And now it is my pleasure to introduce, on behalf of the class of 2001, Meredith Ann Hicks, who will deliver the welcoming address.
Good afternoon, Father Carmen, Dr. Coughlin, Father Joseph Capella, Mr. Blystein, Palatines, honored guests, administration, faculty, parents, family, friends, and my fellow graduates. Welcome to the 44th commencement ceremony of Bishop Eustace. Today we celebrate the many achievements of the class of 2001. I look back at our 4 years at Eustace, and I can't help but compare them to the stages of our life. When we were freshmen, like when we were first born, we were all beginning a journey in a strange and unfamiliar world. We didn't know what to expect, but we knew everything would be different. On that September morning in 1997, we all gathered into the dining hall together. We walked in scared, looking for a familiar face, grasping for a friend, not knowing who to trust or who to confide in. We eventually found a welcoming voice and a warm smile, and we began friendships that would touch our lives in greater ways than we could have ever imagined. That first year, we were so much like babies, depending completely on those around us. We depended on our teachers to help us relearn everything we might have slept through in eighth grade. We depended on the upperclassmen to teach us the ropes. They taught us what's expected at Eustace, how many books to carry to class, and how uncool those ugly gray blazers really were. From their example, we eventually stopped arriving 5 minutes early to class, and we eventually realized that calling freeze prep times was something only freshmen do. We depended on our parents for everything. We needed them to drive us everywhere, to not mind so much when our dinners got cold because our coach let practice run late, to love and support us when we felt dejected and alone. Most of all, however, as freshmen, we depended on each other. We needed one another for friendship and for acceptance. We reached out to our friends when we felt scared and confused. But most of the time, we just needed to know that we were not alone. We soon learned, just as infants do, that the only way we can grow is by taking a risk. Babies have to risk falling in order to take their first step. In order for us to grow and develop, we too had to take risks. Challenging ourselves with honors courses or starting a friendship with someone outside our group of friends. Taking these risks showed that we were ready to enter the next stage of our life, our sophomore year. As sophomores, we became toddlers, more comfortable with our surroundings, but still young in our thinking. We were still too concerned with the superficial. How our hair looked and what other people thought of us were the basis of our lives. We became more independent, however, which showed our growth. We began to walk on our own without having to desperately grab the hands that were holding us up. We started to get more involved at Eustace, taking harder courses, joining an extra sports team or club, making new friends, and strengthening bonds with our old friends. Like toddlers, we began to use our voices, speaking up in class, and even among our peers. We began asking lots of questions of ourselves. Who am I? What am I good at? What are my goals and what is important to me? We learned that these questions can only be answered by the guidance of God. We found His guidance in the advice of parents and teachers, of coaches and of friends. Like the toddlers that we were, we made some mistakes and we stumbled often, but there was always someone over our shoulder to pick us up and urge us forward. Our second year at Eustace forced us to grow up a great deal. We realized the importance of hard work and the benefits of being ourselves. We all began to grow when we started motivating and challenging ourselves instead of leaning on the people who were helping us to walk. As juniors, we were in the midst of our adolescence, much more secure in our position, but wanting so much to stretch our limits. We began to break away from our old selfish tendencies, and we began to think of others. Some of us became involved in ministry and community service, showing our love for God by loving those in need. All of us started seeing ourselves in a new way, as part of a greater plan, no longer living in our own self-centered worlds. This realization is perhaps the greatest discovery we have made throughout our time here at Eustace. Last year, we became much more independent, and we had to be, for there was more freedom given to us by our parents and by our school. For the first time, we were allowed to take electives. We obtained our driver's licenses, and after much pleading, we convinced our parents to extend our curfews. With these new freedoms obviously came many more responsibilities. It was more important as juniors than ever before to study hard, raise our grades, and start thinking about college. We were responsible to wake ourselves up early on Saturday mornings to take those horrible SATs. But more importantly, we were responsible to stay true to ourselves and to God in the process of solidifying our values and our identities. Like teenagers, we were journeying closer and closer into adulthood. Pressure and stress mounted as decision-making became a daily task. And we continued growing when we faced these decisions seriously and with courage. At the end of last year, we waved goodbye to our adolescence. The class of 2001 was finally ready to experience the challenges and joys that senior year brings. Now, we are all truly young adults. This year, we have experienced relief and disappointment, rejection and acceptances. We have spent hours completing our piles of college applications and months waiting to find out where we'd be spending the next 4 years of our life. We all knew this was the last year to make memories together, so we packed them in. Our last field day, our last homecoming, our senior trip, and our senior prom. This past year, we've laughed and cried with our friends, became closer to our families, and even closer to ourselves. We have grown into adults, secure about who we are and how much we have to offer the world. We have learned this year more than ever that our parents do know what they're talking about. We have even learned that teachers at Eustace aren't tough because they're mean people who want everyone to fail, but because they are truly caring people who want so much for us to learn and for us to grow. Some of our teachers this year even became our friends, sharing their experiences and wisdom with us. They have done so much more than teach us grammar, history, and chemistry. They have taught us about life. We have grown up. We are ready and able to accomplish our goals. All we have to do is keep trusting in the wisdom and experiences we have gained from this great school, and keep trusting in our loving God, who makes all our dreams come true. So as we celebrate the many achievements of this great class, I want to leave my fellow graduates and their families with a short poem by Pamela Dugdale, who says this about growing up. For all the time, very quietly, they are changing. Before long, you are waving goodbye to them at the school gates. A moment more, and you have a teenager on your hands. A flicker of time, and they are leaving home, an independent person. But holding within them always the little children they once were. Not just the happiness and fears, but of all the times beyond recall, when the world was new, and there was everything to learn. Eventually, we have to let go of their hands. But the joys we knew before, remembered or lost, will be a part of us all forever. So to all of those who are close to us, friends, family, and teachers, we say thank you. You have helped us grow into the men and women we are today. And it is because of your love that we will never be the same again.
It is an honor for me to be here today as principal of this truly remarkable school, and so wonderful to be holding your graduation ceremony outside in this, our quadrangle, which provides such a beautiful setting for this most momentous occasion, the graduation of the class of 2001 from Bishop Eustace Preparatory School. Yesterday, in attempting to finalize some of the last minute arrangements for today, I had the occasion to call Mrs. Lisa Sacchetti, the president of the Bishop Eustace Parents Association. Dr. and Mrs. Sacchetti's daughter, Christy, is graduating today. As we were conducting our business, the conversation turned to the weather and what it would be like today. Mrs. Sacchetti reminded me that when her son Paul graduated in 1998, we did indeed hold graduation in the field house. Only the second time in 18 years that it was held in the field house. She expressed the hope that our graduation would be outside today. Well, Mrs. Sacchetti, yours and a whole lot of other people's prayers were answered, and here we are. I must tell you, though, when a shower came through this morning at 6:30, my confidence for the day was just a little bit shaken. During the faculty orientation this year, I asked the faculty to challenge their students. More specifically, I asked them to challenge their students compassionately. I think they have done that in an exemplary manner. In that same talk, I also spoke to them about change and the ability that all of us must develop in these ever-changing times to recognize change and adapt to it. In this regard, I told them of a little book that I had read in August, which was entitled, Who Moved My Cheese? The book was written by Dr. Spencer Johnson, and it is a simple parable that reveals profound truths about change. It is a somewhat amusing but interesting story of four characters who live in a maze and look for cheese to nourish them and make them happy. Two of the characters are mice. Their names are Sniff and Scurry. Two are little people, beings the size of mice, who look and act a lot like people. Their names are Hem and Haul. These four imaginary characters depicted in this story are intended to represent the simple and complex parts of ourselves, regardless of our age, gender, race, or nationality. Sometimes we may act like Sniff, who sniffs out change early, or Scurry, who scurries into action, or Hem, who denies and resists change as he fears it will lead to something worse, or Hall, who learns to adapt in time when he sees when he sees changing leads to something better. Cheese, in this story, is a metaphor for what we want in life, whether it is a good education, a good job, a loving relationship, money, a possession, health, or spiritual peace of mind. The maze is where you look for what you want. College, the organization in which you work, or the family or community in which you live. To the soon-to-be graduates of the class of 2001 today, please know that you most certainly will experience change, sometimes profound, in your lives. In many ways, you already have. Also understand that how you recognize and respond to this change will play a major role in helping to determine the quality of your life. Recognize change for what it is, embrace it, and wrestle with it, and you will enjoy a very rich and fulfilling life. My wish for you as you go forward from graduation today is that in whatever maze in which you find yourself in future years, that when your cheese is moved, you will be able to locate a new supply because you have prepared yourself to do so. And that you realize that a major reason why you are able to adjust and find the new supply is because of the solid, Catholic, value-centered preparation you received at Bishop Eustace. Also understand that no matter what changes you may be experiencing in this school's family tradition, you are always welcome at these doors. Thank you very much. And now, having fulfilled the requirements of the Board of Trustees of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School, the following will receive diplomas. Melissa Marie Abruzzi, Christina Marie Adinolfi. Louis Amoriello III. Jill Elizabeth Andwood. Dana Rita Antonelli. David Charles Arnold. Michael James Asman, Jr. Brett Audino. Stephanie S. Avila. Thomas M. Bailey. Brian Michael Baldwin. Ryan Albert Balf. Lauren Nanette Benaz. Celine Kim Bantz. Robert Edward Beauchamp. Michelle Marie Bernardi. John T. Beelan III. Matthew Bollard. Peter Borak. Stacia Marie Bottis. Lisa Nicole Vitalico. Danielle Elizabeth Brett. Lauren Elizabeth Briglia. Robert Broadwater. Madeline F. Burgoyne. Stephen Joseph Calamito. Jeffrey Dale Campbell. Marina Michelle Capicazza. Ashley Ann Capalbo. Stephanie Lee Capella. Carly Marie Cardillo. Gustav Caruso. Genevieve Catania. Charles Paul Coco III. Maria Celeste Cadario. William Anthony Colarulo. Natalie Marie Consol. Maria Christina Cordero. Danielle Catherine Costa. Frank Croce. Justin David Sisk. Kimberly Michelle Delawisio. Catherine Elaine Deacon. Adrian M. Del Quadro. Amanda Marie Denti. John A. DeSilvio, Jr. Kevin Michael DeSchmidt. Joseph Michael DeStasio. Kate Elizabeth Doan. Laura Doyle. Michael Joseph Derzell. Taylor Amanda Ebling. Sarah Marie Eckhart. Christina Patricia Espinal. Courtney Rose Esposito. James Andrew Fallon. Joseph John Farrell. Danielle Marie Fagenbutz. Chelsea Marie Fish. Kelly Carolyn Catherine Flynn. Mary Ellen Elizabeth Foley. Kelly Ann Foran. Kelly Ann Fox. William Frankie. Juan C. Garcia. Kimberly Gasparon. Peter Andrew Gaston. Margaret Elena Gaddy. Irene George. Andrea L. Giordano. Lauren M. Giosa. Christopher J. Gleva. Jonathan M. Goins. Lourdes Yvette Gonzalez. Michael F. Grogan. Joanne Marie Guerreri. Derek Blake Haas. Aaron Michelle Haley. William A. Heath. Stephen Joseph Hendricks. Meredith Ann Hicks. Mary Catherine Homer. Robert William Hunsberger. Kristen Margaret Ioneary. Christina Marie Inamorato. Stephen Francis Jemrogowitz. Raina Marie Johnson. Teresa Elizabeth Johnson. Lance Ernest Jolly. Michael William Jones. Gabrielle Elizabeth Kay. Nicoletta Marie Kennedy. Michael Paul Klodnicki. Gregory Thomas Koch. Kristen Ann Karankowitz. Francesca Michelle Maria Cedrone LaPenta. Matthew William LaPorta. Daniel B. Larkin. Kimberly Ann Lee. Joseph Patrick Leahy IV. Mark P. Lund. Michael Leinard. Thomas Irving McGuire II. John Paul Cruz Mangalinden. Megan Erica Manning. Jeffrey D. Maranto. William Paul Marchianti. Brian Michael Marletto. Caitlin Marie Marquardt. Siobhan Lakeisha Massey. Kenneth Paul May. Amelia G. McCracken. Kimberly Ann Miller. John Christopher Mirmanesh. Cameron Ross Morgan. Yeah. Jennifer Elizabeth Moylan. Bria Grace Murray. Stephen Nace. Anne Elizabeth Nesipour. Joseph D. Nelson. Locke Nguyen. Valerie Lynn Nielsen. Jenny Marie Nywood. Anthony Raymond Nordo. Ashley Marie Olson. Anthony Opperman. Jeffrey Michael Orem. Carolyn K. Wozakowski. Carolyn Ann Page. Christina Louise Paparone. Michael John Paris. Maria Alejandra Para Orlandoni. Daniel John Patterson. Brian Earl Peak. Laura Kathleen Pearson. Michael R. Pellissieri. Judith Ramosa Perez. Mariana Rose Perry. Jason Joseph Persichetti. Ryan Robert Petrillo. Christine Petrangolo. Lauren Marie Petrangolo. Carly Renee Plantulli. Catherine Lee Poniatowski. Valerie Paula Priscilio. Janelle Christina Pratt. Peter Prisbakowski. Albert Michael Pugge. Timothy Devin Quigley. Anthony E. Regina. David Richard Ross. Christy Eve Sacchetti. Michelle Lynn Sandoli. Amanda Lene Scappa. Schneider. Brent F. Selby. Kevin Sentner. Julia Scherf. Angela Simone. Karen Louise Slachetka. Andrea Gail Smoraski. Mary Elizabeth Smith. Rachel Marie Smith. Stephanie Michelle Spina. Kathleen Margaret Sullivan. Stephanie Lauren Sulo. Gina Nicole Taglianetti. Joseph William Tallarico. Dolores Lynn Thomas. Elizabeth Bray Tomlin. Michael Anthony Tremonti. Melinda Yakransky. Stephen W. Yutke. Michael Raymond Virchio. Christina Marie Vatis. Ryan Edward Wade. Tiffany Lanai Wallace. Leslie Ann Waller. Michael H. Walton. Natalie Ann Weber. Chen Hong Wong. Congratulations, graduates. And welcome as alumni of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School.
Last Friday evening, our annual senior award ceremony was held. The following students of the class of 2001 distinguished themselves in the following particular areas. General Excellence Awards were presented to Celine Kim Bance, Frank Croce, Taylor Amanda Ebling, Chelsea Marie Fish, Kelly Carolyn Catherine Flynn, Juan C. Garcia, Erin Michelle Haley, Meredith Ann Hicks, Jenny Marie Nywood, Maria Alejandra Para Orlandoni, Laura Kathleen Pearson, and Stephen W. Yutke. The awards for excellence in the study of theology and history were presented to Frank Croce. The awards for excellence in the study of English were presented to Taylor Amanda Ebling and Laura Kathleen Pearson. The award for excellence in the study of mathematics was presented to Jeffrey Dale Campbell. The award for excellence in the study of science was presented to Kimberly Ann Miller. The awards for excellence in the study of German were presented to Kimberly Ann Miller and Stephanie Lee Capella. The awards for excellence in the study of Latin were presented to Frank Croce and Jenny Marie Nywood. The award for excellence in the study of French was presented to Danielle Catherine Costa. The award for excellence in the study of Spanish was presented to Daniel John Patterson. The award for excellence in the study of health and physical education was presented to Kristen Margaret Ioneary. The award for excellence in interdisciplinary studies was presented to Genevieve Catania. The award for excellence in the study of art history was presented to Maria Alejandra Para Orlandoni. The award for excellence in the study of instrumental music was presented to Maria Cristina Cordero. The award for excellence in the study of vocal music was presented to Lauren Elizabeth Briglia. The Scholar Athlete Award was presented to Kelly Carolyn Catherine Flynn. The Leadership Award was presented to Francesca Michelle Marie Cedrone LaPenta. This year, all 9 students received the Summa Cum Laude Award, which is the award recognizing students who satisfy the basic requirements and maintain a 3.85 cumulative grade point average. This award was presented to the following students: Brian Michael Baldwin, Lauren Elizabeth Briglia, Maria Cristina Cordero, Danielle Catherine Costa, Joseph Michael D'Estasio, Raina Marie Johnson, Siobhan Lakeisha Massey, Kimberly Ann Miller, and Locke Nguyen.
Each year, the Alumni Association awards a $1,000 scholarship, which is presented to the college or university of that senior who exemplifies the ideals and philosophy of the Alumni Association. This student is selected by a committee made up of faculty and administration. It is my honor and pleasure to present this year's alumni scholarship to Valerie Priscilio.
In 1984, the alumni faculty of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School, with the cooperation and blessing of the Palatines, established a $1,000 scholarship award to be given each year to a member of the senior class. It is my great honor on behalf of the alumni faculty to present this alumni faculty scholarship to Stephen Francis Jamrogowicz.
This year, the students receiving the St. Vincent Pallotti Awards are Meredith Ann Hicks, and Peter Presbukowski.
The Parents Association has established the Reverend Ralph F. Fernino Memorial Scholarship to be awarded to a male and female graduate who, during their time at Bishop Eustace Preparatory School, has embodied the characteristics that best exemplify the joyous spirit of Father Ralph. These graduates demonstrate exceptional dedication to and love for Bishop Eustace. They demonstrate a faith in God that is manifested within the day-to-day context of their vocation as a member of our school community. The scholarship amount of $2,500 for each student is now awarded to the following: Mr. Stephen Francis Jemrogowitz. And Ms. Ann Elizabeth Nezapur.
You have been reminded a number of times this weekend that today represents an ending that is also a beginning. Indeed, the very ceremony itself is structured that way. A few minutes ago, Meredith provided us with a salutation, and in a few minutes, Celine will provide a valediction, a farewell. Endings that are beginnings are not always easy. There's a certain amount of anxiety that's involved in leaving behind what is familiar and loved for what is untested and unfamiliar. We Christians have wonderful examples in dealing with separation anxiety, and they are the disciples of our Lord. You may recall from St. John's Gospel when our Lord informed his disciples that he would be leaving them and that they'd have to go out on their own, they did not meet the announcement with unbridled enthusiasm. What they said to him was, "Let us go with you." But of course they couldn't. But remember also what our Lord said to them: "You will not be left alone." And they cowered with that anxiety for a little while in that upper room. But it's so appropriate on this Feast of Pentecost to recall that when the Holy Spirit came to them, these somewhat cowardly men went out on a mission and changed the world. And that's the situation that you find yourself in this afternoon. Because today you're leaving behind what I know were four wonderful years at Bishop Eustace Preparatory School. For the unknown, for college dormitories and classrooms and careers and families, and like the disciples, you will not be left alone, because you take with you the wonderful example that you've had for 4 years at Bishop Eustace from faculty members and classmates who showed you day in and day out how the Christian life is lived, and the wonderful example of parents who cared so much about you that they were willing to sacrifice to give you the very best, a Catholic high school education. And like the disciples, you will be men and women on a mission, because Bishop Eustace will have succeeded on the highest levels when in those colleges and careers, by the quality of your lives and your examples, you lead other people to Christ. So on the part of the Diocese of Camden, I congratulate you on a job well done, and even more important, on a mission well begun. Thank you.
To render the farewell on behalf of the class of 2001, please welcome Celine Kim Vance.
Thank you for attending the celebration of the commencement of Bishop Eustace Preparatory School's class of 2001. Fellow graduates, today is the last time we will be together as a complete class. However, the intangible unity we have with each other will last forever. About 4 years ago, we were gathered in the St. Vincent Pilati Chapel wearing our gray wool blazers, our first symbol of unity, for a different type of commencement ceremony. We were spoken to for the first time as a class and guided towards a path to success for the next 4 years. However, what we did not yet realize as apprehensive freshmen first becoming part of Eustace was that no speech could fully prepare us for our new life here. This school was unique, and not just because of its outstanding reputation and academic renown. It would be the people that made it special. As we headed like a flock of sheep to begin our high school career, we discovered that being part of Eustace was more than anyone could have told us at orientation. As freshmen, we were understandably afraid as we embarked on this journey. In fact, If anyone took a good look around the field house during an assembly, I'll bet it would take mere seconds to tell which corner seated the freshman class. As freshmen, we sat very close together in a tightly packed cluster. It seemed as if our unity had begun on day one. We all came in knowing few people and knowing even less about what lay ahead. The teacher seemed pretty scary and the upperclassmen were rather large, so we stuck with some of the first friends we made and clung to them. As we became better acquainted with the Eustace environment during our sophomore and junior years, we were united in the self-confidence and independence we started to develop. Someone looking at us as sophomore and junior classes when seated would notice we were much more spread out than freshman year, symbolizing our independence as a class and even our personal growth in Eustace. We adjusted to many changes, even in field day, and look forward to our first formal dances. Also, we were able to tackle a heavier workload in classes, and we became more involved in our school community. With these challenges, we made more friends, even with teachers, many of whom some of us will never forget. Through their love of teaching, they inspired us with lessons of immeasurable value. And because they believed in us, we were able to believe in ourselves. Finally, in the far corner of the gym, we sat together this year as seniors. Hopefully, by the time we made it over there, our experiences helped us continue the outstanding tradition of excellence as examples for the rest of the school. Whether we were ready or not, we were role models. Our corner was where all the other classes looked, whether it was to see how we would react in an announcement, to see what cheer we would start at a sporting event, or to see if we really did sing the words to the alma mater. So how do we look as a class? Today, we look as close-knit as when we were freshmen, but in a different way. Now, we do not need to be close to a few friends to feel secure. We want to sit with our entire class to feel complete. We have come to realize how important our close friends are and how fortunate our lives are. Although sometimes we long to relive the memories we did not even realize we were making at the time, and sometimes we feel a little scared, now we have our past experiences to help us. As those past experiences at Eustace have shown us, succeeding is not easy. We had to pull a few all-nighters doing research papers, and we also had extracurricular commitments, in addition to the overwhelming stress of the college application process. Those problems seemed trivial, however, when some of our classmates chose paths other than Eustace, and we experienced the death of our beloved principal, Father Ralph. However, whether our experiences were good or bad, we underwent them together, and they made us who we are today. Maybe some of us came to Eustace only expecting academic excellence. However, our tradition is that of a winner in every aspect, and our education was only the beginning. We grew in our understanding of God and developed a closeness as a Christian community. We succeeded by working together, and we learned that dealing with hard times defines our character and became stronger people. Even if we hadn't planned on it, we gained life lessons. After much watching, following, and experiencing, it is now time for us fellow graduates to stand up and show what we have learned. It is interesting that we could not wait to sit in these chairs, but now that we are here, it seems as if they were set up too soon. Right when we feel the closest to each other, it is time to leave. However, as Winston Churchill once said, "Do not think of this as the end. Do not even think of this as the beginning of the end. Rather, think of this as the end of the beginning." Eustace provided us with a tremendous foundation. Now our goals extend even further. It is our turn to teach, to use our knowledge, strength, independence, and faith to reach out to others beyond this community which has prepared us and to fulfill the rest of our dreams. As I speak to you now, I realize that just as when we were freshmen in the chapel for the first time, there are no words now that will fully prepare us for the future. We simply have to live it ourselves. Because of our experience here at Bishop Eustace, we are changed people. We have developed our unique gifts, made lasting friendships, and have become part of this community in service, action, and character. In a few minutes, we will walk our separate ways. Hopefully, we will be able to use our newfound knowledge to step forth with leadership, wisdom, and ministry.
we are the first graduating class of the new millennium. When we reflect back years from now on our high school experience, it is not the chapters of a particular textbook which we will remember the most. It is the people who shared those hard bleacher seats with us, the same people who sit with us here today. We laughed at each other, cried with each other, and shaped each other as individuals. To everyone who has helped us become who we are today, a sincere thank you. Hopefully, we will always keep our memories, lessons, faith in God, and lifelong friends within our hearts. Classmates, we have sat in all four corners of the gym, and now we can stand on our own two feet. Let us step forth with confidence and realize that the future belongs to us. We are completely together as the class of 2001 for one last time. As we commence into the world on our own, I can think of no better way to honor Father Ralph and reflect positively on the unity of our class and community than to continue on as ministers. Let us cherish our memories, realize our possibility, keep our faith, and take our knowledge and abilities with us wherever we go. Members of the class of 2001, we have come a long way together, and today we will stand up and move forward. Congratulations.
The class dedication to St. Vincent Pallotti will now be given by the president of the class of 2001, Francesca Michelle Marie Sedone LaPenta. Will the members of the class of 2001 please stand and remain standing during the dedication?
We pray to you, St. Vincent, father and patron of our school, that we, the graduating class of 2001 of Bishop Eustace Prep, may be forever attached to our alma mater and devoted to the principles of Catholic faith and American democracy taught to us. You, who dedicated your life to the holy works of the apostolate, obtained for us from our Lord and the Blessed Virgin, Queen of Apostles, a heart full of ardent zeal, so that like you, we may dedicate ourselves to the apostolate mission that all people may become one fold under one shepherd. Amen. St. Vincent Pallotti, patron of the universal apostolate, pray for us.
Thank you.
Could not be here mainly because of what we call the vocation crisis in the church, the need of more of the faithful responding to the call to serve in the priesthood and religious life. We are told that proportionally, this is not yet the worst such crisis the church has ever faced, but it is difficult enough and is affecting the way we live the church today. The reasons proposed for the crisis are many and varied. The most frequently repeated one being that the superabundance of choices offered to people today keeps many from even considering the possibility of a religious vocation. It is certain that we are inundated with information, communications, choices, and thousands of voices vying for our attention. May I suggest as a thought for you today that what really matters, what will make life a celebration instead of a drudgery, is to choose well. It is to choose with solid criteria and lasting values. It is to choose as human beings. To be human means, in the first instance, to be created in the image and likeness of the Creator, and to bring something of the divine to everything we do. To choose well and wisely is to free oneself from the confusion and complication of so many proposals and invitations. Freedom is not what happens when I'm sitting on the edge of the bed at 6 a.m. and have the entire day ahead of me to do with as I decide. Freedom is real when it is activated, when it is realized. Then our freedom passes from the virtual to the real. Ages ago, Socrates said that the unexamined life is not worth living. I suggest to you today that it is the uncommitted life that is not worth living. In the name of the Board of Trustees, in the name of the entire Palatine family, lay faithful priests, brothers, and sisters, I congratulate you on so much hard work already accomplished and so much of life already lived well. May God grant you good health, peace of mind, a courageous spirit, and a sincere love for all of creation, that each of you will make a lasting and creative impression on some part of our world. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who made heaven and earth. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord let his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you kindly and give you peace. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
We take this opportunity to thank you for your attendance at this, our 44th commencement. And we ask that parents, relatives, and friends remain in their place until after the dignitaries and graduates exit. Thank you and good afternoon.
Thank you.